One minute,
Beth.
Okay?
Right.
Hey,
Jizzak. Because I tell you what you got to do, you got to put your rolls in the oven.
Oh, boy.
So hurry up. Come on.
No, I am. Okay?
Yeah, because your rolls are going to be ruined if you don't, unless you put them in.
No. This way. This one.
1 minute.
Yes, okay?
Yeah, okay. Right, one minute.
That's my mutton. See?
There's potatoes to be for lunch, there's buns to be baked, but there's Marmite to be eaten. 90 miles away, Sophie's parents are having a rather more anxious time.
I think you've got to be realistic. I'm delighted that she's making the progress she is. And, you know, let's see what the next 2 years bring. I'm really worried that I've set her up to fail, because I know it's going to be very, very, very demanding. It's the work ethic thing. They have to be ready, they have to be punctual, they have to get up, they have to have a certain amount of independence. And I'm worried that there are things I'm aspiring for Sophie, but I'm not being realistic.
By 10:30, the hotel is a hive of activity.
You've got brown bits on. We've got brown bits on. Look, that's got brown bits all over. That's what we're trying to stop.
Fox's aims to make students more disciplined in their timekeeping and their work rate, so they can fit into jobs in the outside world when they graduate. Sophie's a first year and is still inclined to wander. The buns remain unbaked, Sophie's gone AWOL, and Martin has a hunt on his hands.
Sophie!
Chef Sara has an inkling where Sophie might be. The smallest room, the safest refuge.
Go on, Soph! Quick, we've got to finish the bread off and get it in the oven. Come on. We've got to go check your bread. It's in the oven. Well, I haven't got a minute, Sophie. Come on.
By the time Sophie emerges, the head chef is on shift.
Come on, you! Come on! Otherwise, you're going to get anything done. Go on after you.
Come on.
Sorry, Bill. I'll do it again.
And which Bill are you talking to? Me?
Yes, you.
Right, come on. Let's get on.
Bill, I'm sorry.
Okay. That's all right. I accept your apology, but it's got to stop.
Come on, let's do it again.
Yeah, let's go and get
it. No. I'll do it and make it.
I agree. I accept your apology, but you've got to get on.
Listen, next week, if this carries on, we're not making any bread. Now go to the kitchen and go help clean the kitchen.
Bread.
Go help them clean the kitchen then.
Come on.
Come on. Let's go help clean the kitchen.
Come on. Go, girl.
Right, you go help clean the kitchen, then we'll sort out the bread next week. If you behave.
Can I clean this table?
No.
Phil has spent 35 years in catering, but students like Sophie have forced him to moderate his ways.
I've had to change my total life around because I can't swear at them, I can't batter them, I can't burn them, I can't kill them. Yeah. So when I first walked in here, I would have been always in trouble. I don't think I'd have a job today. Honestly, you know. So I've had to turn that all around. Yeah.
Because you don't chat at them ever, do you?
Now and again, when they're being really silly, or they need a kick up the backside.
The Fox's minibus has dropped the guests off at the theme park, and Tom is raring to go.
We're dinosaurs!
David Attenborough. Inside this wonderful park, this is where the dinosaurs live.
Tom's tour of world cultures begins in Egypt. Undeterred by his Egyptian experience, Tom acquaints himself with Hindu deities.
Oh.
I don't know why I got the hold on this.
And then the grand finale, a Wild West water ride. It's been a grand day out for Tom, feeling he's enjoying it rather more than his friend. Surface, it's all perfectly well ordered at Fox's. There's tables set and waiting for dinner at 6 sharp. French onion soup with chicken supreme to follow. But any hotel has its upstairs, downstairs soap operas. Outside, the staff are on afternoon meal break. And beneath the colour-coded Fox's uniforms, unruly passions are seething in the sea air. Daniel from kitchen staff has got an eye on Michelle from waitressing.
Sit where my gorgeous girl.
Oh, darling.
All right.
But there's a problem. The problem is called Ben, and he and Michelle are already an item.
Yes. No.
But Dan no. has a plan.
Pray that him out.
When?
No, it's
today.
Mine now.
You're going to do well, you have done.
I will.
When?
Today.
What time?
That Ben. After this will work.
Never tell her.
The Dan-Michelle triangle is becoming a bit of an issue when all three of them are together on the same shift. Wherever you find Michelle, you find Dan in suspiciously close proximity. This isn't doing much for the kitchen skills Dan is supposed to be learning. He's mooning about, getting in the way of the horseradish. The thing is he never actually plucks up the courage to come straight out with it. So he's written Michelle a note. If you were Ben, you could be forgiven for getting a bit hacked off with this sort of carry-on. There's your girlfriend. And there's some bloke hanging round waiting to give her a love letter. Either way, Dan's mind is completely off the job. And it's not as if Michelle is that keen anyway.
I don't want it. I'm not talking to her.
The rivals conduct themselves with intense politeness.
Jimmy.
Excuse me, Dad.
Jimmy, Ben.
Excuse me, Dad.
The guests are happily oblivious to the kitchen drama. The sweet trolley is out. Tom's time at Fox's was well spent. He now has the skills to live independently and help out in his local cafe.
Do you wish you were still a student here?
No.
Why?
I'm happy how I am now, not a guest. I like being a guest.
Old habits, learned at Fox's, die hard.
A long period from being
tough. I shouldn't do that anymore. It's not my responsibility. This isn't level. There.
Tom has fond memories of his kitchen days too.
Tom wants me a spoon on the table for old time's sake.
Yes.
He wants what?
Me a spoon on the table.
And the shanty. And the shanty.
Tom, get up! Right! You're not going!
Happy days at Fox's Academy.
Remember that then, dear?
Yes.
That's brought back memories.
Many of Fox's guests come with organised parties, There's a lot of people with physical or learning disabilities, and there's a fair sprinkling of parents of students. Some people just like it.